To get into this whole Atlanta reunion, because Kenya was really just getting dragged left, right, and center. She had no leg to stand on, but I thought it was okay, way better than the trailer, but still below par. And here's why.
Why do you talk about Kenya's marriage every chance you get when you still don't know where your husband was in Florida and what he was doing there?
That part.
That's hilarious.
Hey guys, it's Murad Murali. Hopefully you guys are doing well today. Back at it again with another video. If you haven't subscribed, guys, where's my carrot cake? Hold on. If you haven't subscribed, guys, click that button for daily and consistent content. Head over to my Instagram, my Patreon, my merch. Click that button, guys. Subscribe to the channel. And let's get into this, because I just watched the reunion, first part, and I thought, why not get into it right now and get it out to you guys so we can really discuss this. Now, I feel like Kenya was basically being dragged from, you know, all the corners. Doesn't necessarily mean that I am happy for her being dragged, but that is basically the notion, the discourse of how this reunion went. Candy was extremely quiet and so was Cynthia, and that in itself kind of irritated me. I feel like the first reunion episode, all of them need to be integrated, but really this was just Portia, Drew, and Kenya. It was really just focused on those three, and I just feel like Cynthia needed to be there. And really and truly, she was just unfortunately just there, and that was really it for me. And I feel like we could have wanted more. I feel like her only real storyline was her marriage, and even that wasn't rated high with the episodes, but whatever, we don't need to discuss that. But yes, Kenya was being dragged left, right, center, but I'm kind of irritated. I feel like the way she apologized for wearing, you know, Native American outfits as costumes, I feel like it was a great apology. She understood where she went wrong, and you know, she took accountability for the matter. But at the end of the day, I don't like how Bravo like to put this understanding that the black housewives need to be really aware and be apologetic for anything that they have done that is controversial. But we've had several white housewives who have done far worse, and I don't believe many of them have been forced to be accountable for their actions or told immediately XYZ. I just feel like this has been really pinned down on Kenya. I'm not trying to justify the situation, but we have people like Bethany Frankel, we have people like Ramona, people like Brandy, who've said some awful disgusting stuff.
Luann's costume is so disrespectful. I think she's tone deaf when it comes to cultural stereotypes.
She asked me, what Asian I am because of my eyes, they're squinty.
They'll just be, they don't get to a point. It's called, your weave is busted, your tracks, you have this, your ratchet.
I can't swim?
You're a black person. All my black friends can't swim. That bad?
They don't go in the pool because they will get their weave f***ed up.
There was another moment that she was extremely racist as well, that they didn't air also. We were at Yolanda's house. I said something and Brandy goes, "Ah, oh, you shouldn't even be here. You need to go to Miami with where all the Latinas are. You don't need to be here in Beverly Hills." It was all, every time she could throw like a little racial thing, she would throw it.
She brand new to Joyce, you know, the Latin housewife, from saying the only thing that was on camera was something about if you're black, you can't swim. But there was other things going around about, you know, the fact that you get out of this country, XYZ. It was a very racist kind of rhetoric that I was seeing. And I don't think she was forced to apologize. Yes, it was, you know, a different time. But a lot of these White House wives have gone away with so much. I think quite a few on Orange County as well. Even Dallas have said stuff. But yet it's Kenya who is really being pinned down on. I don't like that kind of unfair narrative. I really don't. Yet you want to celebrate talking about Black Lives Matter in general on the show, but then specifically stuff like this, you don't really care for the White Housewives and what they've done. No, I don't like that. I really don't. And I feel like even Andy himself said something in an interview about somebody from Dallas or Orange County, correct me if I'm wrong, guys, about how, you know, we should separate the controversial opinion that they have to the fact that they're just on a show for entertainment. So why you have so much energy to defend these White Housewives when it comes to Kenya? It's a very different story. Seems very sus to me. I feel like Andy Cohen was going pretty down and pretty harsh on Kenya as well. And this is coming from me. I'm not a big Kenya fan, guys. If I choose between Kenya and Portia, I choose Portia. But I try to remain objective. You know, discussing how the fact that have you really been unblocked by Mark? Phone him right now. You know, really going in on him. This question was sent in really by you. I feel like he does this all the time to Kenya. I've noticed this. Sometimes it's, you know, needed because she's very unnecessary. But sometimes it's just relax. I feel like I'm kind of overdrew. Over the last couple of episodes as well, but especially this reunion, I'm overdrew. They have faked so many storylines. The way she was crying so quickly, I don't think Kenya was even talking about her son. She thought it was very cringe, to be honest with you. Very cringe. But for Kenya to say, "Oh, that was very uncomfortable to see," I think it was very uncomfortable for everybody to see you with a camera crew knocking at your mother's door, waiting for a response. That was also very cringe and uncomfortable if you want to discuss cringe. So that in itself didn't make any sense to me. But the way Drew had these tears that were coming out of nowhere and were not really falling out of her eyes, where were these tears, Drew? Where were these tears? Where were these tears? Where were they? I don't understand. And then immediately you're quite happy on the next scene, and that to me sounds just, you just comes across a little bit dubious, as well as the fact that this whole Tampa storyline was very fake. This whole Tampa storyline, guys, was just used as something because, you know, clearly the girl really has not much going on in her life. I felt like she was a great housewife to begin with, but I've just fallen out of love with her and I'm kind of over her, to be honest with you. This whole Tampa stuff was not needed, it was unnecessary. Yes, for him to go around for 3 days is nonsense, but they amplified it into something else, which it wasn't, and it just was irritating for me, in all honesty. Porsha dominates. Porsha continues to dominate reunions. Yet again, her personality comes through, and I'm very content and happy. I feel like, you know, for Kenya to scrutinize her activism is really unfair, because if we really want to talk, what has she been doing for the platform that she has in terms of activism? Only really taking down Porsha's. And I completely understand Porsha. Why would you invite someone to your PSA when they haven't been great for you or supporting you? You don't want that energy around you because they could do something that, you know, could negate from that and neglect it. So I'm not really, like, I get what Porsha's saying. And Kenya was, you know, she was trapped here and there, and she just ended up apologizing for stuff, because all you really can do. You can tell that there comes a point of time where some of these housewives guys are kind of over it. That's what I get for, you know, Kenya. She's kind of over it, some stuff here and there, and she was just apologizing. But I just feel like overall this reunion, this first episode wasn't that great. It wasn't that bad, but it was better than what the trailer was showing. And I'm just kind of over Drew. I don't know, LaToya came in hot, and you know, I'm here for that. She came in straight, called a SpongeBob, and was, I'm ready. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like I'm liking LaToya more now than I am liking Drew. I just feel like Drew is just forcing and faking a lot of the stuff, and it really irritates me. Like, just go away now. Like, I just feel like you're just doing the most, and it's just like, do the most, but don't make it forced. Do you know what I mean? Do as much as you can, but don't make it forced. Don't come up with some fake storyline. This whole Tampa stuff was just annoying, and apart from that, I don't know. I'm just not really here for it, to be honest with you. I'm kind of over Drew, really over Drew. What I like about Kenya and Porsha, when they do have their riffs back and forth, they allow each other to speak. They allow each other to have dialogue, and they were having proper conversation. And Porsha really got her when she was like, you know, you want to give, want people to have this grace for you, but you don't extend that same olive branch to anybody else. Because when it came to the railroad moment 6-7 years ago, you're still using that against me to this day, but you wouldn't like anybody else doing that to you. So the hypocrisy is pretty straight there. But I feel like if you've been on a show for 6-7 years, it's very easy to point out anybody's hypocrisy, because they may have done something in season 6 or 5 that they've forgotten about, and they're changed by season 12. Yet again, Phaedra's being mentioned. I love it, because she's such a major point for the show, talking about Apollo and Phaedra and the fact that Kenya regrets all of that. Of course you would. In hindsight, you think you're a fool for doing all of that, but you do what you need to do to maintain your peach, and that is what Kenya was doing. And I'm glad she did that, because she gave us very great scenes in 5 and 6, but people will hold it against you in the future, and that is just a negative to some of her actions. And overall, yeah, I don't know, like, I just feel like the Kenya should have said a lot more. I just love how Candy reads Drew all the time, because it makes a lot of sense. If you're married to somebody and they disappear for 3 days without zero communication, that is disgusting. I don't know how you guys can continue forth with that, regardless of whether you're going to meet up with guys and girls, or regardless when you're, you know, going to a beach to do what, I don't even know. It's ridiculous. No relationship, whether you're married or not, none of that can, no friendship, no relationship, no marriage can work without communication. You need to communicate with somebody, no matter how severe you think an issue is. Otherwise, the other party does not know what is going on, and things become imbalanced. You must communicate with your partner or with your friend. It's really that simple. Especially if you're a grown adult, if you don't know how to communicate, then I just simply don't know for you. I really don't know. When it comes to, you know, Kenya and her mother, the strained relationship is always brought up all the time. And I just feel like she just hasn't received proper therapy. She's addressed it here and there, but she's throughout, especially in the last four to five seasons, she's carrying so much of that pain. And you can see that it's projecting everywhere. When you project onto other people of your traumatic issues that you've gone through, you immediately become what? Self-destructive. And that is what I've just been seeing in the last couple of seasons when it comes to Kenya. I don't know who's coming and going back since for the next season. I'm hearing Phaedra's coming back. I feel like that could possibly happen, but Candy would leave, which I just find annoying. Like, if you want to leave, then just leave, I guess. But I do want Phaedra back, or Nini back. Nini is definitely coming back, we know that. But I'm here for those who are coming back. I just feel like other housewives have done far worse than Phaedra. What Phaedra did was very, very low. But I feel like people like Teresa as well, who did stuff. And, you know, other housewives have done really bad stuff. So I just feel like for entertainment purposes, they do need her to come back. But I just feel like she needs to come back as herself. She needs to be realistic. She needs to apologize properly, and she just won't do all of that. But I feel like, you know, she is doing a Watch What Happens Live associated show, so that could be a signal point. But apparently the producers know that the season was trash, know that the ratings were trash, and want to do something about it massively. And I just feel like, you know, I don't know why they're hiring so many young girls. I don't know what they're trying to do with this. Why are you coming with the whole, let's hire Fallon and LaToya and Drew and the young girls? I don't get this kind of movement the producers of Atlanta are trying to do. And I feel like it hints at a little bit of ageism. I don't like ageism because we're all going to get old one day, and then other people will be throwing at us what we've been throwing at other people. It doesn't make any sense. What I feel like we should have is elder women on the show, like Karen Huger or Giselle, you know, in that range when they're in the 40s, maybe early 50s, you know, something like, we need women like this who have a caliber, who have wisdom, who can throw shade, who have the family, who have the money, who are going through issues. I feel like that is what is iconic for a housewife, and that is what people need. So I feel like that is what they should put into the format now and hire somebody like that. And I feel like they really need to get rid of Cynthia. I'm so sorry. I know everybody says that, you know, every housewife has to be ratchet or rude or drama or whatever. I'm not saying that, but I just feel like she has played her role in the show. She's developed herself now in the show. We've seen so much of her character. Her character is now played out. Yes, she's there as a friend. She helps to reignite friendships. I'm not saying that we need somebody who is really dramatic to replace Cynthia. I just feel like I've seen enough of her life now. We've seen her getting married twice on the show. Like, I just feel like I don't need to see any more of Cynthia. I'm not gonna lie to you. When I watch the episode and see the scenes of Cynthia, or even Candy sometimes, I'll just be forwarding it all because it's just tiring for me. Like, I don't know. Like, I just feel like this cast is the ensemble. Portia cannot carry this cast on her own. Kenya cannot carry this cast on her own. Neither can anybody else. You need Phaedra and Nini there. They were the two most dramatic individuals. Season 9 was great without Nini because Phaedra was there, and everything was focal around Phaedra and Portia and Candy. And I just feel like these two need to come back into the show. I'm not mad at LaToya getting a peach now, because I feel like she is really bringing it. If LaToya was not in the season, we wouldn't have half to talk about. We really wouldn't. It would just be the Kenya and Portia show, which to me is tiring as it is, because these guys have been beefing for 7 to 8 years. Like, I just don't understand. Patch it up now and call it a damn day. Just call it a day, guys. I don't know what Kenya was talking about her Native American history. It's from West Virginia. West Virginia? West Virginia. West Virginia? West Virginia, what the hell are you talking about? You had so many months to come up with a perfect lie, but clearly you couldn't even do that. So I don't even know, guys. Make of this reunion what you wish. I feel like Kenya was getting dragged, and, you know, people are coming for her. Even the host, Drew, Portia here and there, even Cynthia was trying to say a few things, and even Candy was saying a few things. Few things justified, few things not. I don't think that Kenya was coming for Drew's son by saying that it was cringe, because it was just a cringe scene to see, and if she wanted to do that, she wanted to do that. But I don't think that she was coming for her son because she addressed her son. If you mention somebody in a tweet, it doesn't mean you're directly coming for them. It doesn't. So I don't know, that to me doesn't make sense. It really doesn't. I feel like Portia and Kenya look physically, you know, they all look great. And I feel like Candy's outfit is actually growing on me. I didn't like it at first, but seeing her at the reunion, sitting down and talking, it's kind of growing on me. But I feel like she was very quiet in this first part of the reunion, and I don't know why that was. I feel like more questions should have been raised to her. Definitely. But in the trailer, we see Cynthia getting a lot of flack because of her, you know, pandemic wedding, and rightly so. I feel like it was a very dumb move for them to make. I don't know why you couldn't have just moved it. Does it have to be 2020 or whatever the hell? I don't know what, 2020, 2010 or 10, 2020, I don't know. It didn't have to be that. You could have just delayed your wedding to sometime the year after when pandemic, you know, restrictions loosened, and you could have had a huge wedding. I don't know why you had to do, I don't get it. And no shade, no tea, but Mark Hill's outfit at Cynthia's wedding was a hot mess. This glittery suit, I don't know what you were doing, why you bought this in Party City, and why you decided to have your wedding as like in this kind of way, where I don't like to talk about people's weddings. I think it's very overall disrespectful, so I'm not going to really divulge in that. But I just also feel like Mark Hill's outfit wasn't it. That's all I want to say. Let me know your thoughts are, guys, when it comes to this. What are your thoughts when it comes to the reunion? Whose outfits did you think were best after mine? Let me know your thoughts are, guys, when it comes to this. Subscribe to the channel. Click that button, guys, for daily and consistent content. Subscribe, comment down below, who did you like? Do you guys agree or disagree with me? I'm keen to hear your comments and your views on this reunion, and I'll catch you guys soon for another video.